Dear student, we are continuing with aldehydes and ketones. Exam time question. First question is, what is crossed aldol condensation? Answer is, these are the condensation reactions where different varieties of aldehydes containing alpha hydrogen, they condense in the presence of dilute NaOH to give the different aldol product. For example, we take one reaction of acetaldehyde with propionaldehyde. So these are two different varieties of aldehydes. They are condensing in the presence of dilute NaOH to give this hydrogen from alpha carbon. It is migrated to this oxygen and product will be CH3CH. This oxygen takes this hydrogen OH and then we have CH3CHO. This is aldol. Now this aldol contains one aldehyde group and one OH group, so its name will be 3-hydroxy 2-methyl butanol. So this is crossed aldol condensation where the different varieties of the aldehydes, they are condensing to give you the product. Then we have another crossed aldol condensation. SCHO condenses with CH3CHO in the presence of dilute NaOH. Product will be this hydrogen, alpha hydrogen, from here migrates to this position. Oxygen changes into OH group and this becomes CH2CHO. This is also aldol. Name of this compound is butane 4-ol-1-ol. So these reactions where different varieties of aldehyde they are condensing, they are called as the crossed aldol condensation. Similarly, benzaldehyde can condense with acetone in the presence of dilute NaOH. It will be giving you the product CHOH, CH2CO, CH3. And this product, if it is heated with H positive ion, it will definitely eliminate a water molecule and will give the product like this. The compound is 4-phenyl but 3-ene-ol. So these reactions which are involving different varieties of aldehydes or aldehyde and ketone, they are called as crossed aldol condensation. So this was our first question of this lecture. Then we have the second question, what is Perkin condensation? It involves treatment of benzaldehyde with acetic anhydride in the presence of sodium acetate. It will give you the product like CH double bond CH CO O CO CH3. Water is eliminated. This reaction is carried out at 453 Kelvin. And then it is hydrolyzed with water. Then we get cinnamic acid as a major product. This is cinnamic acid plus acetic acid. So these are the two questions, very important questions, which can be asked in the examination. First is the your aldol condensation, and then we did the Perkin condensation reaction. Now we coming to the third question. That is another important question of aldehydes and ketones. Question number 3 is, what is the action of ammonia on formaldehyde? So this is our question number 3. What is the action of ammonia on formaldehyde? Answer is, it gives urotropin, a medicine given to the patients suffering from urine disorder. So it involves the treatment of 6 molecules of formaldehyde with 4 ammonia to give you CH2 6N4, plus you get 6 water. This product is urotropin, a medicine which is given to the patients in urinary troubles. The structure of urotropin is, this urotropin, when treated with concentrated HNO3, it will give you CH2 6N4 NO2. Now, structures of urotropin and this is called as RDX. RDX. Urotropin has a structure just like benzene, where 2 nitrogen, they are not attached directly, but they are alternating, and the nitrogens, they are joined through CH2 group to another nitrogen. So this is the structure of urotropin. It is treated with concentrated nitric acid. The structure of this is your structure of RDX. So these are 2 important compounds which are produced during the action of formaldehyde with ammonia. Then we have very important reaction, benzoin condensation. Start with our question number 4. What is benzoin condensation? Answer is, it involves treatment of pentaldehyde with KCN to get benzoin. So we treat 2 molecules of pentaldehyde heated with KCN, you get benzoin. This is our benzoin. This was our 4th question, how to get benzoin. Then we have very important question, aldehydes, they restore the pink color of the Schiff's reagent, but ketones, they do not restore the pink color of the Schiff's reagent. Then we have Tischenko reaction. Question number 5 is, what is Tischenko reaction? Answer is, it involves treatment of acetaldehyde with aluminium ethoxide Two molecules of it, they are condensing to give you ester. This is ethyl acetate. So this is our very important reaction, that is Tischenko reaction. Then we have intracondensation. What is intracondensation reaction? Intracondensation means the condensation within the molecule, a molecule which is having two aldehyde group when treated with dilute NaOH, then this undergoes self-oxidation and reduction, we get the product like this. One of the aldehyde group get reduced to alcoholic group, another aldehyde group is oxidized to carboxylic group. So these type of reactions, they are called as intracondensation reactions. We get, since NaOH is there, we will be getting sodium salt of this. Loss of water here. This is called as glycolic acid. Then we have very important question. How do aldehydes differ from ketones? So this is a very important question. How do aldehydes differ from ketones? First is, aldehydes are more reactive as compared to ketones due to least plus I effect of one alkyl group. Second is, on reduction, aldehyde they give primary alcohol, while second ketones they produce secondary alcohol. Third, aldehydes reduce tolerance reagent and failing solution, but ketones do not reduce tolerance reagent, failing solution as well as Benedict solution. Then aldehydes give large number of polymerized products, but the polymerized products of the ketones, they are difficult to analyze, or they could not be identified what polymerization products are produced from ketones. Aldehydes show immense number of aldol condensation reactions, but ketones show very limited number of ketol condensation reactions. So these are the major differences between aldehydes and ketones. Whenever aldehydes, they are reduced with the zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl, that is Clemens reduction, they produce alkanes. Similarly, ketones, they produce alkanes, but having one or two carbon more than that of the alkanes produced by aldehydes. Then we have the ketol condensation. What is ketol condensation? Question number 8. What is ketol condensation? Ketol condensation, it involves the treatment of acetone with barium hydroxide when two molecules of acetone, they condense together to give you ketol. It is a product just like aldol, since it contains a ketonic group as well as a alcoholic group. That's why this product is called as ketol. So answer is, two molecules of acetone, they are taken and they are treated with barium hydroxide solution. Then we get ketol. This is called as ketol. Then we have question number 9. Give polymerization reactions. Answer is, aldehydes undergo lot of polymerization reactions and they produce lot of compounds during polymerization. For example, when aqueous solution of formaldehyde is evaporated to dryness at 373 Kelvin, we get product This product is called as polyoxymethylene. if gaseous formaldehyde, three molecules of formaldehyde in the gaseous form, they are kept in a bottle in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, they condense to give a polymer which is called as trioxane. This polymer is trioxane. So gaseous formaldehyde, when it is allowed to kept in a bottle containing a drop of sulfuric acid, then it polymerizes to give you the trioxane. Then six molecules of formaldehyde, when condensed in the presence of lime water, that is calcium hydroxide, they will produce formose sugar. It is a sugar just like glucose. This is called as formose sugar. So formaldehyde, when condensed in the presence of lime water, it gives you formose sugar. When we have condensation reaction of acetaldehyde, three molecules of acetaldehyde, when condensed in the presence of 298 Kelvin, they give product . This is called as pyrrolidehyde. If four molecules of acetaldehyde, they are condensed at very low temperature, we get a product like this, CH3CH OCH CH3 OCH CH3 OCH OCH3. This product is called as metaldehyde. So these are the polymerization products of aldehydes and ketones. We get metaldehyde, pyrrolidehyde during the polymerization reactions. Then we have very important reaction of aldehydes and ketones. That is our question number 10. That is, what is HVZ reaction? That is Helvoet-Jelinski reaction, where alpha hydrogens of the aldehydes, they are substituted by halogens. So these reactions, they are very important. Question number 10 is, discuss HVZ reaction. This is called as Helvoet-Jelinski reaction. So in this case, what we are doing, we are taking alpha hydrogen containing aldehyde, treating it with Cl2 in the presence of red phosphorus 423 Kelvin. Product is monochloroacetaldehyde. It is further treated under same conditions. Loss of HCl, you get dichloroacetaldehyde. It is further treated with Cl2. It will again eliminate hydrogen and will produce chloral. This is HVZ reaction. Similarly, for ketones, we can proceed. 3Cl2 is taken, heated 423 Kelvin. Product is trichloroacetone. These reactions are very important in doing the large number of organic conversions. So these reactions, they can be taken into account for conversions. Then we have reactions of ring. Since aldehydes and ketones, they contain double bond in the substituted group. So whenever they are nitrated, they are sulfonated, or they are subjected to halogenation, they always direct the second incoming group to the meta position. So all the double bond containing groups, whenever in aromatic aldehydes and ketones, when they are undergoing the reactions in the benzene ring, they always prefer to give the meta products in the case of the reactions of benzene ring. Then what are the uses of formaldehyde? 40% aqueous solution of formaldehyde. We know it is known as formalin and it is used to preserve biological specimen. They do not decompose in the formalin solution. Benzaldehyde is also used as a flavoring agent in tannings of hides. खाल पे से बाल उतारने के लिए लेदर टैनिंग में दे आर यूज्ड बिकॉज लेदर इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टैंड एंड देन इट इज यूज्ड इन द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ लेदर आर्टिकल्स. पैरल्डिहाइड इज आल्सो यूज्ड एज ए हिप्नोटिक मेडिसन. वेनिलिन ब्यूटाइरल्डिहाइड बेंजोफिनोन दे आर ऑल कैम्फर. दे हैव स्वीट फ्रेग्रेंस दैट्स व्हाई दे आर यूज्ड इन द फ्लेवरिंग कंपाउंड्स एज ए फ्लेवरिंग एजेंट्स. In the preparation of large number of chemicals like chloroform, ketones and acid anhydrides etc. So this is regarding the important questions for exam time for aldehydes and ketones. In next lecture we will be taking the important questions of carboxylic acids. Thank you very much.